Alright, what's going on, guys? Your boy Sly here, back again with another Mass Effect video, and this time we're diving into part 3 of my Mass Effect 2 playthrough. Now, if I remember correctly, last time, yeah, we just opened up Grunt, we just got Jack, we finished up, what was it, Horizon? Was that? Yeah, that's exactly where we were. And now we're about to go finish everybody else out. I know we have some more dossiers from the Elusive Man, so I think we're gonna go get Thane, and probably the Justicar next, so let's see what happens. First, let's talk to this guy. He was a little unresponsive last time.
Shepard, I need something.
Oh, wow, already?
To talk to you. I don't know.
I'm listening. What's the issue?
Something is wrong, Shepard. I feel wrong. Tense. I just want to kill something with my hands. More so than usual. Like it's not my choice. Like I just want to... I don't know. See? Why do that? What's wrong?
Pure Krogan probably starts more aggressive than most. I'm not seeing this as a particularly big shift.
Doesn't matter if it's normal. I'm not. I'm not used to this noise. I want control. When we're moving, fighting, I focus. But here, my blood screams, my plates itch. And even you are just noise. I'm tank-born. What is this?
Don't know if I can help, Grunt. Sounds like we need one of your kind to look into this.
Most off-world Krogan are warriors. Doctors don't leave the homeworld to Junka. I won't ask you to go there. I will control this.
Joker can get us to the Krogan homeworld. I need everyone at their best.
Thank you, Shepard. I don't like this. Fury is my choice, not a sickness.
Alright, well. So, one thing I did do while you guys were gone, I did a couple side missions. Nothing big. What was it? The Jerihi Space Station. You know, where they had the uncontrolled, like, robots. What else? A couple mining things. Like, got a lot of, what was it? Got a lot of, like, platinum, palladium, stuff like that, but that's all about it. I didn't do any major missions at all. Basically 3 hours of mining is what it turned out to be.
I got thoughts like little bugs crawling in and out of my head. I can't stop them. You know I have a history with Cerberus. You know how far back it goes?
I'll listen to anything you have to say, Jack.
Your pal, the Elusive Man? Never seen him before, but Cerberus raised me. First thing I remember is my cell door in a Cerberus base. They did experiments, drugged me, tortured me. Whatever chance I had to be normal, they stole it by trying to turn me into some superbiotic. The doctors, the other kids, every one of them hated me. They let me suffer.
There were other children in the base?
I didn't know much about them. I was kept separate. They hated me just like everyone else there. When I broke out, I had to fight through them all. I showed them, but there's a loose end I need to deal with.
What did they hope to gain by torturing a little girl?
It was something about pain breaking down mental barriers and how it might clear the way for a more biotic power. I'm sure there was a payoff due at some point, but I wasn't gonna see it. I was wired up in a cell.
They tortured you just to see if they could make a strong biotic? That's it?
Wasn't in a position to ask, Shepard. All I know is a little girl crying in a cell, begging for the pain to stop.
How did you get out of there?
There was some kind of emergency, and I made a break for it. The other kids came out of their cells and attacked me. So did the guards. I just killed everything in my way and ran. Guess my biotics had developed faster than they thought. I managed to get a shuttle off the ground, drifted until a freighter picked me up. The crew used me, then sold me. That's my uplifting escape story.
You're absolutely certain that Cerberus was running the facility?
I was a kid, but I wasn't dumb. I know how to listen. It was Cerberus. Don't care how far down the chain it was. They thought they were so clever. Turns out, mess with someone's head enough and you can turn a scared kid into an all-powerful bitch. Fucking idiots.
I'm gonna talk to the Elusive Man, and he'd better have some answers.
He'll just deny everything. That's not what I'm after anyway.
I found the coordinates in your files. I want to go to the Telton facility on Pragya where they tortured and drugged me. I want to go to the center of the place, my cell. I want to deploy a big fucking bomb, and I want to watch from orbit when it goes.
You've lived with this your whole life. Why do this now?
Like I said, I found the coordinates in your files. You can't expect me to just sit on information like that.
Attacking our allies is going to derail our mission. Not a smart move.
The files say it was shut down after my escape. It's been abandoned for years. They going to care if I blow up a garbage dump?
I'll set a course for Pragya.
I owe you, Shepard.
Yeah, you do. And before I quit last time, I remember Miranda wanted to see me also. So I guess she's going crazy as well.
The commander has put together an impressive team. I've never worked with so many aliens before.
They're a small army. We might just pull this mission off.
Oh, and I still forgot groceries. I'm gonna set that man up.
Shepard, I find myself in the unpleasant position of asking for your help. I don't like discussing personal matters, but this is important.
Miranda, you're one of my crew. Tell me what's on your mind.
You remember what I told you about Father, building a dynasty? There was another reason I went to Cerberus for protection. I have a sister, a twin, and he's still hunting her. Cerberus has kept her safe, until now. She's living a normal life on Illium, safe and hidden from my father.
So you think your father has tracked her down?
Precisely, Commander. My sources indicate he knows that she's on Illium. I've tried to keep her hidden without impacting her life, but I'm out of options. He's too close. I need to relocate my sister's family before it's too late.
And the obligatory butt shot.
What do you know about your sister?
She's my genetic twin. We're identical. But she deserves a normal life, and she's going to get it no matter what.
Does your sister's family know about this? Are they okay with being relocated?
They know nothing. They're completely uninvolved. Normal. I told Cerberus, and they're coming up with a positive reason to move the family.
What do you need me to do?
My father is extremely persistent. I'd like to go to Illium when Cerberus is moving the family to make sure none of his agents get too close. My contact's name is Lantea. She'll be waiting for us in the lounge near the Nos Astra docking bay.
All right then. Well, might as well see if Garrus needs it too. Sorry, Rupert.
Shepard, I'm glad you came by. I've got something. I may need your help. You remember Sidonis, the one who betrayed my team? I found a lead on him. There's a specialist on the Citadel, name's Fade. He's an expert at helping people disappear. Sidonis was seen with him.
What happened? How did Sidonis betray your team?
He tipped off the Mercs, told them where our base was. He drew me out with a false job, then let the Mercs hit my team. My men weren't prepared. They tried to hold them off. By the time I got back, there were only two survivors. They didn't last long. All 10 of them dead. Because of him.
What are you planning to do when you find him?
You humans have a saying, an eye for an eye, a life for a life. He owes me 10 lives, and I plan to collect.
You sure that's how you want to play it?
I'm sure. I don't need you to agree with me, but I'd like your help.
Where do we find Fade?
I've arranged a meeting. We'll meet him in a warehouse near the Neon Markets down on Zakara Ward. Thanks, Shepard. I appreciate you taking the time to help me.
All right, then. Well, let's go see what the top deck's up to.
Jacob wants to speak with you, Commander.
I knew it.
Commander, sorry I'm a little unfocused. Personal matter. It won't affect my duties.
The Yeoman said you wanted to see me. What's this about, Jacob?
As I said, it's a personal matter. I don't want to waste our time if it turns out to be a goose chase. But... well, I got pinged by a ghost the other night. Family.
I'm listening.
My private log got an update about the Hugo Gernsback, the ship my father served on. It sent an SOS last week, reporting a crash and requesting a rescue. Shepard, that ship went missing 10 years ago. I hadn't talked to my father for 3 years before that. I've buried everything but a body. I'm not convinced it isn't just some automated distress signal ticking over. It's been too long.
I'd think you'd be more excited that your father might be alive.
He wasn't around enough for me to have bad memories. It's an old, well-healed wound. But if he's actually alive and needs help... I also want to note that it's not normal procedure for distress calls to be routed to the Normandy. This was passed to my personal log through Cerberus filters.
Tell me about the Hugo Gernsback and what it was doing.
Privately held frigate. I looked over the mission brief when it disappeared. Nothing stood out. Typical research and grab operation. Find an uncharted planet, stake a claim, and establish as large a presence as you can as fast as possible to shut out competitors.
Any signs that this was a Cerberus front? Who passed this to you?
I doubt the elusive man would let a direct operation stake hold this long. If there's a link, it's probably just about money. Cerberus needs diverse holdings to fund projects like, well, you. And whoever sent this my way covered their tracks. Someone could be fishing for favors, or thought it would get under my skin. Who knows with that bunch?
I think we can spare the time. Pass the coordinates to Joker.
I appreciate that, Commander. I don't expect more than dusty old bones, but it'll be good to close the record.
Shepard, important news. Know you're busy. Have to deal with the collectors. Planning attack. Too important to wait. Just receiving data. Still processing, analyzing likely scenarios. Not sure how to begin. Too much intel. You remember our talk? My work on genophage modification?
You stopped the Krogan adaptation to the genophage.
Part of a team. Scientists, all different types. Blood pack mercenaries captured former team member. Malin, last seen on Tuchanka, might torture him, make an example. Recovering Malin would be a personal favor to me.
Do you think they found out your team updated the genophage?
Unclear. No way to determine until we get to Tuchanka.
We'll go to Tuchanka and see if we can find your team member.
Go to Tuchanka.
Appreciate it. My assistant, my student, want to see him safe. Malin last seen outside Erdnot territory. Scouts might have seen Blood Pack. Talk to them or Clan Chief.
Anything in here? I'm really missing my Kestrel armor right about now. Like, on my Xbox, I have, like, all the DLCs, you know, a million different saves, all kinds of stuff, and playing this brand
no
new...
No messages for you, Commander.
This brand new PC playthrough. Just goes to show you how much all that stuff really, really makes a difference. Alright. To do first. Let's go get that dude's groceries. We'll help Garrus out over there too. Come on. Let's take Grunt out to see the sights. Ooh, 7. All right. 30 health, 15.
I've found references to a forger named Fade in CSEC crime reports, Shepard. Perhaps that is a good place to start looking.
I hear this is the best place for food on Zakaroward.
You heard wrong. This is the best place for food on the whole damn Citadel.
Welcome. This is the Zakaroward Transportation Hub.
Wait, what am I doing?
That's all for now.
Thank you for using Avena. Have a pleasant day.
I wonder what a Presidium fish would taste like. I'm telling you, there are no fish up there.
Speaking of fish, let's go get that guy. God, I left so much undone at the Citadel.
The people want to hear your story, Shepard.
Uh-huh.
Khalisa been seen in Al-Jilani, Westernland News. I interviewed you 2 years ago when you first became a Spectre. You presented your case very well on camera. Do you have a minute?
What, so you can try to do another smear job on me?
Now, Shepard, you may object to my methods, but we're on the same side. You're bad, you're news. I just want to give your story its due. Sources claim you were at the heart of the Presidium during the Battle of the Citadel. It's fair to say the course of the battle hinged on your words. If true, you told Admiral Hackett to assist the Destiny Ascension, costing hundreds of human lives, and securing the continued dominance of the Citadel Council.
The Turians lost 20 cruisers. Figure each had a crew around 300. The Ascension, the Asari Dreadnought we saved, had a crew of nearly 10,000.
But surely the human cost.
The Alliance lost 8 cruisers. Shenyang, Emden, Jakarta, Cairo,
Seoul, Cape Town, Warsaw, Madrid. And yes, I remembered them all. Everyone in the Fifth Fleet is a hero. The Alliance owes them all medals. The Council owes them a lot more than that. And so do you.
Commander Shepard, first human Spectre. Hero of the Battle of the Citadel. Check vid. We get it? Great. Bull rushed on my own show.
Bitch! Oh wow, it's all foggy on the PC. It's pretty neat. Yeah, get it!
Can do for you?
I noticed you're one of the groundskeepers for the Presidium. Do you know if there are fish in the lakes?
I get that question a lot. I think it's right behind where's the restroom? Those are reservoirs. The Presidium's own supply, independent from the water storage tanks in the wards. The only place I know of on the station to get a live fish is Delaeus Sonnesi's gift shop.
When I pour a glass of water, it's the same stuff that tourists throw garbage in?
No, they purify it first. If some Solarian or human bacteria gets left in, and a Turian or Quarian drinks it, they could die. Everything would be so much simpler if we all had the same DNA. But no, the universe loves diversity.
Where's that gift shop?
In the market downstairs from the bar. Delaeus sells aquariums. Fish are the largest pets most station residents can get a permit for.
Thanks for your time.
No problem. If you get up to the Presidium, check out the Demio flowers across from the conduit. They're coming in very nicely.
What will it be?
Hear about anything interesting going on around here?
I serve drinks. You want to know what's going on? Check the news. I don't know why humans always ask me that.
I want the strongest thing you have.
Easy enough.
This is... it's green.
And guaranteed to knock you on your ass. Unless you're Dextro DNA like me. If you are, it'll kill you.
Take it.
Anything else?
Let's have another one.
There you are. Anything else?
Not done yet.
I'm impressed. I've never seen anyone drink three of these. Anything else?
Hit me again.
How about we mix it up a little? This is genuine Batarian ale, uncut. Don't ask how I got it. I've been serving here 8 years. I've never seen anyone have this and stay on their feet. Anything else?
Do it.
Okay, for you, something special. This is Krogan liquor, Rincal. You'll set off radiological alarms after you drink it. Should I pour you a quad?
Oh yeah, put more of the stuff in the thing where stuff goes in.
Your funeral, pal.
know what's good? Cash. Alliance Corsair.
I'm Commander Shepard, and this is my favorite store on the Citadel.
Yes, it is.
Why are you so interested in fish from the Presidium?
It's so decadent. Eating a fish from the Presidium would be like screwing Shaira.
Ugh, Asari is so squishy. Where are you supposed to get a decent grip?
Didn't mean to bother you.
Don't let it happen again.
Humans. Since they rescued the Council, they think they own the damn station.
I'm Commander Shepard, and this is my favorite store on the Citadel.
What do you want?
I overheard you talking about the fish on the Presidium.
What, you mean there actually are some?
Sure, I just got one. I have it with me now.
I'll pay you for it.
What, you don't think I'm hungry? I went all the way up to the Presidium for this. Why should I give it to a random Krogan?
I'll pay you a lot for it.
Oh, all right. It's obvious you really want it. Here you go.
Weren't you saving that money for a new gun?
Who cares? They wouldn't let me use it here anyway. Thank you, human. Many Krogan must have dreamed of this day, but I get to be the first.
It's just a damn fish. Guns are better than fish.
1,000 credits. I guess that's a little bit.
This looks like the place. The Forger thugs should be inside.
I just got a refund and exchange, and I was told to pick up a new Omni-Jail converter here.
I don't think you have the right place.
No, they said to go to the warehouse. This is the warehouse.
Fade, you're not quite how I imagined you.
Looks can be deceiving. So, which one of you wants to disappear?
I'd rather see you make someone reappear.
That's not the service we provide.
Make an exception. Just this once.
Damn it. Quick! Shoot them! Shoot them, you lumbering!
Too slow.
Why do I even bother?
We're looking for someone. A client of yours.
Not mine. I'm not Fade. I just work for him. Sort of.
I knew it.
Well, then maybe you'd like to tell us where to find him.
Yes, of course. He's in the factory district. Works out of the old prefab foundry.
I know the place.
Oh, he's got a lot of mercs there. Blue Suns. Harkin thinks they're protecting him.
How the hell did Harkin end up being the Fade?
Well, he got fired from CSEC a while back. He used his knowledge of CSEC and their systems to help a few people disappear. Then he made himself disappear, and Fade was born, so to speak.
Interesting. But it changes nothing. We still need to find him before we can get to Sedonis.
I'm looking forward to seeing Harkin again.
I'm sure he'll be excited to see both of us. We'll need to go to the transit station. I can get us to him from there.
So I can go?
Sure, but if we don't find Harkin, we'll be back for you.
Oh, good.
Helicab.
Look, it took me a long time to get this refund. It's a Cision Omnigel converter. He said there'd be one waiting for me.
Do you have a service order?
No, I got the refund, made the exchange, and then he said go to the warehouse.
There he is.
Shepard?
Don't just stand there! Stop them! Stop them!
Run all you want, Harkin! We'll find you!
Ahead.
Take cover!
$600 in the trash. Nice.
Combat systems engaged.
I'll put them down.
I'll take the shot.
Moving to cover.
To the left.
Yeah, right on your ass.
Nice shooting.
One less to worry about.
My pleasure.
I need some ammo.
Hmm.
Oh boy.
I hate you!
Harkin's in here somewhere. I can smell him.
Understood.
Moving to cover.
Heads up! And stay there.
Impact event.
One less to worry about!
Note to self, clear out enemies and then hack stuff.
Look out! Yes! Perfect!
as dramatic.
Hitting cover!
Die!
I hear you. Be all this easy.
What the hell is Harkin up to?
Harkin's finally gone completely bad.
He was always a pain in the ass, but I'm in no mood for his games. If he doesn't cooperate, I'll beat him within an inch of his life.
You seem to be getting tense, Garrus.
Harkin may know why Sidonis wanted to disappear. If so, he knows why we're here, and I don't want him tipping Sidonis off. See that?
I saw something.
He's getting ready for us.
You still planning to kill Sidonis when we find him?
That's the plan. It'll be quick and painless, unlike everyone he betrayed. He'll be spared the agony of a slow death. It's more than he deserves, but as long as he's dead, I'll be satisfied.
Garrus, do you really think killing Sidonis will make things right?
I have to do this. I don't expect you to understand, but please, don't try to stop me. I'll pull the trigger, and I'll live with the consequences. All I'm asking is that you help me find him.
What do you think Harkin's got waiting for us in there?
Not sure. It looks like an industrial complex. Heavy machinery. Could be anything. Something's in there. Probably more blue suns. Harkin's kind of trapped himself in a corner. He must have something in store for us.
Well, there's one way to find out.
Right behind you.
This should come in handy.
That will come in handy.
Shepard, I have patched into the warehouse scanners. The crates in the transport carriers overhead are rigged to explode when dropped.
Good to know.
Heads up!
I need cover! Just turn around!
Damage.
stand there if you want to, bud.
Nice shot!
Moving to cover.
So, Fade, couldn't make yourself disappear, huh?
Come on, Garrus. We can work this out. What do you need?
I'm looking for someone.
Well, I guess we both have something the other one wants.
to hurt. Maybe you should just tell us what we want to know.
Maybe. I still haven't heard what you want.
You helped a friend of mine disappear. I need to find him.
I might need a little more information than that.
His name was Sedonis. Turian came from the...
I know who he is, and I'm not telling you squat.
Harkin, this doesn't have to be hard.
Screw you. I don't give out client information. It's bad for business.
You know what else is bad for business? A broken neck.
All right. Get off me!
Terminus really changed you, huh, Garrus?
No, but Sedonis opened my eyes. Now arrange a meeting.
I'm going. Yeah, it's me. There's a chance your identity may be compromised. That's why I'm calling. I'm sending an agent. Where do you want to meet? All right, he'll be there. Don't worry, I got it covered. It's all good. He wants to meet you in front of Orbital Lounge, middle of the day. So, if our business is done, I'll be going?
I don't think so. You're a criminal now, Harkin.
So, what? You're just gonna kill me? That's not your style, Garrus.
Kill you? No. But I don't mind slowing you down a little.
You don't need to shoot him. He won't be able to hide from C-Sec now.
I guess it's your lucky day.
Yeah. I hope we could do this again real soon.
I didn't shoot him.
Come on, let's move.
Sedonis better be there. Or I'm coming back to finish the job.
Whoa. Hello.
Harkin's a bloody menace. We shouldn't have just let him go. He deserved to be punished.
Don't waste your time on him. Let C-Sec deal with him now.
Yeah, I suppose you're right. Thanks for helping me with this, Shepard.
Have you thought this through? You know what you're doing?
No, but I'm not turning back now.
It's not too late. You don't have to go through with this.
Who's going to bring Sedonis to justice if I don't? Nobody else knows what he's done. Nobody else cares. I don't see any other options.
I won't mention it again.
I appreciate that. I need to set up. I can get a clear shot from over there.
What do you need me to do?
Keep him talking and don't get in my way. I'll let you know when he's in my sights. Give me a signal so I know you're ready, and I'll take the shot. You better go. He'll be here soon. Shepard, can you hear me?
What's going
Loud
on?
And clear.
Everything's all trippy, look at that.
All right. There he is. Wave him over and keep him talking.
Let's get this over with.
You're in my shot. Move to the side.
This won't take long at all.
You want a Harkin's man? I don't remember seeing you before.
That's it. Just keep him talking a few more seconds.
I was told Harkin was one of the best. This better not happen again.
Oh, it won't. Don't worry.
What? Shit.
Betrayal repaid, Sedonis. That was easy enough.
Clean and simple. Good work.
Thanks for helping me, Shepard. Let's get moving. I need to get away from this place.
Right with you.
That isn't happening. Percent. Nice. It's crazy how big the Citadel is. All right.
CSEC appears to be investigating the death of Sidonis, Shepard. They currently have no leads.
What a shame.
Moving on.
Messages for you, Commander.
Bah! Are you sure about that? You're fired. Oh, that's what stuff I did before you guys. Or before I recorded this. Alright, mark is red. Awakened Oak here. Yeah, that was last time. Source of VI, that was also last time. Kate Bowman. The guy we saved from the biotics last time in Mass Effect 1. Hey, Nolar, that's the guy from, Arachni Labs, Novaria. And a sappy quote. What's next? What should we do? I kind of want to get another teammate, but... Right. that dude his stuff, his groceries, before I forget about it again. Yo, Rupee.
Commander, those provisions you provided were perfect. I owe you. I've already thrown together some of my calamari gumbo. Here, try a bite. Truth told, it's based on an Asari recipe. Seems a little cannibalistic to me with their tentacle heads and all, but they ain't no good grub. Anyway, thanks again. You really came through.
Oh, I wonder if I saw the fish. Feed him before I forget. Easier to do this on a console. The controller.
Probe away. Probe launched.
Away. you. Up again.
I forgot how much I hate this place. See the landing pad? Has to be on the roof, or the vegetation would overgrow it in a few hours.
Shepard, I am picking up thermal signatures everywhere, except at your landing zone.
Something's distorting the sensors.
This was a secret Cerberus facility.
Yeah. They build their equipment to last. Assholes. It was a mistake coming back here, Shepard.
Get a hold of yourself. It'll be okay.
I'm fine. Okay, let's get on the ground.
Get in there and plant the bomb in myself. I want to watch this place burn.
I never saw this room. I think they brought new kids in these containers. They were messed up and starving, but alive. Usually.
This is unbelievable. Facility went rogue.
He didn't say what they were hiding from the elusive man. I remember escaping to this room, fighting here. I saw sunlight through the cracks in the ceiling. Only a half-dead guard between me and freedom. He was begging for his life.
Totally beat you.
Mm-hmm.
This looks like an arena.
That's right. They used to stage fights here, pit me against other kids. I loved it. Only time I was ever out of my cell.
What were they studying?
Hell if I know. Maybe that's how they got their kicks. I never understood anything that happened here.
How often did they do this?
I was in a cell my whole life. Sometimes they took me out and made me fight, filled me with drugs, other stuff. Time gets funny in a cell.
Did other children die in these fights?
I was a kid, filled with drugs. I got shocked when I hesitated. Narcotics flooded my veins when I attacked.
They actually rewarded you for attacking?
I still get warm feelings during a fight.
What the hell was wrong with those people?
I don't know. Doesn't matter now.
Let's keep moving.
Hell yeah.
Security Officer Zimple, Telton facility. The subjects are out of their cells. They're tearing the place up. Subject Zero is going to get loose. I need permission to terminate. I repeat, permission to terminate. All subjects besides Zero are expendable. Keep Jack alive. Understood. I'll begin the...
That's not right. I broke out when my guards disappeared. I started that riot.
Things might have happened that you didn't see.
The other kids attacked me. The guards attacked me. The automated systems attacked me. That doesn't leave lots of room for interpretation. This place is supposed to be empty. Who the fuck shot that Baron? It's a fresh kill.
This should punch through their armor.
Not no shield!
They're moving in close! Just stay down! I'm on it!
Great. They need a morgue. This was a small facility.
I'm saying, some sick son of a bitch killed a lot of kids with these experiments and then checked his work.
Bullshit. I had the worst of it and I made it out alive. strange to be back here. I feel like I'm pissed off. I'm a dangerous bitch, but then I'm a little girl again. Shit, it's complicated. Let's just go plant that bomb. Two-way mirror? My cell is on the other side. I could see all the other kids out here. I screamed at them for hours, and they always ignored me.
Probably because they couldn't see you.
Broke out, but I don't remember it. This is a bad place.
Entry 1054, Telton Facility. The latest iteration of Pergnum went poorly. Subjects 1, 4, and 6 died. No biotic change among the survivors. We lowered core temperatures of surviving subjects, but no biotically beneficial reactions occurred. As a side effect, all subjects died. So we'll not try that on Zero. I hope our supply of biotic potential subjects holds up. We are going through them fast.
This is bullshit. They weren't experimenting on the other children for my safety.
This whole place was built to turn you into what you are.
You don't get it, Shepard. I survived this place because I was tougher than the rest. That's who I am.
You move on, harder and tougher.
It's all fallen to pieces. The subjects are rampaging and Zero is loose. We're shutting Telton down. What a disaster. We'll infiltrate and piggyback onto the Alliance's Ascension program. Hopefully, that will give... Who what? Zero, wait!
Shepard, they started up somewhere else.
Ascension is an Alliance program. It's a school for biotic kids. They don't torture children there.
A lot of this isn't the way I remember it.
There was a lot going on.
I was dumb. I keep my eyes open now, and I always shoot first. We're getting close to my cell, the place I came from. Let's keep going.
Hey, Aresh. It's Kira. Yeah, the intruders are here. You want them dead? We have to talk creds. You promised us lots of salvage, but this place is a waste. Fine, put him down. Then I'm coming in there and we're gonna talk salvage.
What are you doing here?
First we're gonna kill you, then we'll see.
They've seen
kill
us.
Kill them on my order. I want them dead.
Fire in the hole!
Concentrate fire. I'll fly. Or I'm down.
I like how they play peekaboo.
I'll kill you all!
On it.
Affirmative!
Suppression, and I want it now!
Shit.
Fire!
Watch the landing.
Get ready for close combat!
Come out and fight!
Concussive shot, red.
What's that?
Useless. Oh, I'll kill them myself.
Right.
Fire!
Grabbing cover! Fire a high impact shot!
Is my old cell. Whoever Aresh is, he's in there. I want to plant the bomb there anyway. Might as well do it on his corpse.
Oh, Jack. Next time, bypass. Next time.
Come out. We know you're here.
Who are you?
Hiding so
my
well.
Name is Aresh, and you're breaking into my home. I know you, Subject Zero. So many years have passed, and I thought I was the only survivor.
My name is Jack. How the hell do you know me?
We all knew your face, Jack. They inflicted horrors on us so their experiments wouldn't kill you. You were the question, and I'm still looking for the answer.
Looks like you're not the only one pulled back here, Jack.
I tried to forget this, but a place like this, it doesn't forget you. It follows you. I hired these mercs and came back almost a solar year ago. We're rebuilding it piece by piece. I'm gonna find out what they knew. How to unlock true biotic potential in humans. I'm restarting the Telton facility. It will be beautiful.
I wanted a hole in the ground. He's trying to justify what happened by using it?
This place was like a prison. How did you get out?
We all attacked at once as they were taking us to the lab. They would have put us down. But then Jack got loose. When I came to, it was over. The guards, the scientists, and the kids were all dead. And you were gone.
I stopped it. All of it. Maybe the others did have it bad, but what you're doing is just messed.
Everything we went through must have been worth something!
You'd do the same thing to new kids? Wasn't this forced on you?
Some were bought from poor families on Earth or kidnapped from colonies. Most ended up here the way I did. Batarian pirates. They did such horrible things to us. They must have had good reasons.
There's no reason good enough! Are you nuts? You lived it!
We can blow up the place, but that still leaves it. What do we do with another you?
That's easy.
Just leave me here. This is where I belong.
Fuck that!
Jack, he's trapped in his past. You need to move on from yours.
He wants to restart this place. He needs to die.
He's crazy, and he's never gonna restart this facility. You have to let it go. Your past doesn't have to control you.
Fuck! Get out of here. Go! He's not worth chasing. None of it is.
You did the right thing, Jack.
Maybe. This room was my whole childhood. Give me a minute to look around.
Go ahead.
Nothing's changed. But it's all different. I thought that room out there was the rest of the world. I'd pound and yell. Never did any good. Sometimes I dream that I'm back in this bed being tortured. I used to tie the sheets around my wrists and try to rip them off. I want to stop coming back here. I used this table for everything. It was like my best friend. I'd crawl under it to cry. I was pathetic. See the scarring on the wall here? That's where I killed my first man. One of the guards tried to stop me. Instead, I stopped him. Okay, no more wallowing. Let's blow this place to hell.
Say something.
I saw the reports on Horizon, Commander. What you did was amazing. The report mentioned that Ashley Williams was there. How did that go?
It was good to see her.
Do you have strong feelings for her?
What we had together is in the past now.
I'm sorry. Parting ways with someone so close is never easy.
You just get over it.
I understand. Anyway, how may I help you, Commander?
Is there anything I should know?
Nothing right now. Anything else, Commander?
That'll be all.
I'll be here if you need anything.
Alright, let's go get that. That'll go great. Alright, what's next? Let's go to Illium. That'll be nice. Actually, first, let's go ahead and take a look what these places are. Collapsha and Cortasi. Oh, hello, son. Well, that was quick. Tefnut. This place has a lot of Element Zero.
Probe launched.
Like some place you can find in these one of these systems that's just like packed full of Element Zero.
Probe away.
Like these little waves of the chart like go all the way up into the name.
Launching probe. Probe.
All right, that's enough. Well, that was interesting.
We have used half our fuel.
Is probably one of my favorite planets in the game. Let's get Morton for a spin. Thank you.
Welcome to Nos Astra, Commander Shepard. We've been instructed to waive all docking and administration fees for your visit. My name is Karina. If you need information about the area, it would be my pleasure to assist you.
Who instructed you to waive the fees?
The order came from Liara Tassoni, who paid all fees on your behalf. She also asked that I direct you to speak with her at your convenience. She's near the trading floor.
What can you tell me about Nos Astra?
It's an exciting city. We see a lot of new cultures and goods because of our proximity to the Terminus systems. At the same time, Illium is still an Asari world. You should be as safe here as you would be on the Citadel. For your own safety, however, I recommend against signing anything.
What's so dangerous about signing something?
Illium is a free trade world, Commander. Contract term requirements are more relaxed here than on other planets. It's a small price to pay for keeping our competitive edge in goods from the Terminus systems.
You mentioned trading. What gets traded on Illium?
Anything you can imagine, Commander. Illium is a wonderful world for those who can afford it. In order to remain competitive as a Terminus systems port, we've relaxed many of the standards you'd find on other Asari worlds. Most drugs are legal, provided they are labeled properly. You can buy almost any weapon or technology. You can even buy indentured servants.
I can't believe an Asari world would allow slavery.
We try to avoid calling it slavery. All indentured servants on Illium have voluntarily agreed to a term of service. Most choose indentured service as a means to pay off debt or avoid imprisonment. A contract holder is responsible for the well-being of her servants, and a servant's duties are agreed upon before the contract is signed.
You said Liara was here? What's she doing?
Liara is one of Nos Astra's most respected information brokers. Nos Astra is based upon trade. Information is valuable currency, and Liara has done quite well. As I said, you'll find her near the trading floor. She was looking forward to seeing you.
Thank you.
Again, welcome to our city, Commander. Please enjoy your stay.
Customs records indicated Justicar named Samara is visiting this port, Shepard. Your former teammate, Liara Tassoni, may have more information. Her office overlooks the trading floor. You may wish to speak with her regarding the whereabouts of Thane Krios, the assassin on your dossier, as well. Also, I have a message for Miss Lawson. Lantea has reserved a room at Eternity and will be waiting.
Thank you, Edie.
Tired of training employees only to lose them to your competitors? Perhaps Indenture Tech can help. The leading provider of cutting-edge
indenture
tech service. Indenture Tech can provide contract...
You have to give the Asari credit. Illium is a cultural marvel. Humanity can learn a lot from their ingenuity.
No, you don't understand! I lost it somewhere near the trench. Pardon me, I'm on a call.
Asari building structure resembles Hive. Tall buildings filled with drones. Curious social dynamic. Many queens competing for Hive leadership. Odd feelings around Asari. Unfamiliar. Reminders of old fertility contract negotiations.
Are you shorting prefabs?
Why not?
Excuse me, or you
You're Commander Shepard? I saw your... I guess you would say your aura. I'd recognize you anywhere. I was asked to give you a message if I saw you. It's from a friend you made on Novaria.
I met a lot of people on Novaria. Could you be more specific?
I believe the message itself should make it clear. Shepard, we hide. We borrow. We build. But we know that you seek those who soured the songs of our mothers. When the time comes, our voice will join with yours, and our crescendo will burn the darkness clean. Thank you, Shepard. The Rachni will sing again because of you.
I'm glad to hear that you're rebuilding. Are you somewhere close by?
The Rachni Queen is not here. That message is one of many memories I carry from her. I encountered her on an uncharted world. She saved my life. More than that, she gave me a purpose. They are an amazing people, Shepard. The galaxy owes you a great debt for giving them a second chance.
I got that she was grateful. What else was her message saying?
That the first Rachni war was a mistake. Something soured the voices of her people. In Rachni psychology, that would be like mind control, I think. It doesn't really translate. Anyway, she believes you are fighting the ones who did that, and she promises to help.
She thinks that the Reapers caused the Rachni War?
I can't say for sure, but she was certain that her ancestors were forced into war against their will. Her people aren't naturally aggressive. If they made war, it was not of their own doing.
You said the Queen gave you a purpose. What do you mean?
The Queen shared her song with me as I recovered. I saw the Rachni as only an Asari could. They are so beautiful and so vulnerable. They needed someone to purchase things they cannot make themselves. Someone to work within the system. An agent, if you will. I am happy to help. My life as a courier was empty and shallow. Now I'm helping a great race rebuild itself.
You were really comfortable walking away from your old life?
You're concerned that the Queen is controlling me. I understand, but it doesn't work like that. Our minds were in perfect harmony. I saw their beautiful spirit and their need. I knew what I had to do. If some part of that is suggestion, then it was a side effect from their efforts to save my life. I am happy.
Can you tell me where the Rachni are?
I'm afraid not. I don't even have that information myself any longer. After I met the Rachni Queen, that information was removed. It's not painful, but I simply don't remember. I'll remember when I need to. And her caution is understandable. The galaxy isn't yet ready for the return of the Rachni.
Thank you for giving me that information. I'm glad my friend Anaveria is doing well.
Be well, Commander Shepard. You will not see me again.
Alright then.
Holy crap, Shepard? I thought you were...
Shepard? The news said you were dead. What happened?
No, wait, probably classified. Forget I asked. You just have to lie.
It's been a couple of years. I'm Gianna Parasini, Novaria Internal Affairs. You helped me nail Administrator Analeas.
Happy to help. What happened to Administrator Analeas?
He made the one mistake Novaria won't tolerate. He got caught taking their money. He's doing a few years in white-collar prison. More importantly, he won't work in the field again. Sit down. If I remember right, I owe you a beer. What brings you to Illium? You know, that you can talk about.
You ever heard of the Collectors? They're attacking human colonies. I'm gonna stop them.
Damn, Shepard. For me, a tough job involves more paperwork.
Hey, listen, I just remembered something. I've gotta go. Talk to you later. And don't forget to drink your beer.
Always being used.
I'm looking for the best tech upgrades you have.
Of course. I can help you with a consult and figure out what options work for you.
It's expensive.
Welcome! You look like someone who needs high-quality equipment. Feel free to look around. My store has the best tech and biotic equipment on Illium.
Is everything here so expensive? I'd plan to drop a lot of credits today.
Really?
I'm outfitting a team for a dangerous mission. I need the best and I'm willing to pay for it, as long as you work with me.
Well, perhaps I could give you a preferred rate at the kiosk. Here, a small discount, and when I get special items in, you can take a look.
What kind of special items are we talking about?
Oh, you know, schematics, designs. Nothing illegal, but I may not have all the licenses to sell them.
Do you have anything else? Anything not listed on your main merchandise kiosk?
Well, there is one thing. Very advanced design. Not publicly available yet.
That's because it's still in development on Novaria, and illegal for export. Hello, Hermia.
Parasini! You set me up! But this isn't Novaria! You don't have the authority to arrest me!
I don't care whether you go to jail. I've got all the evidence I need to find you out of business.
Do you have the authority to seize the schematic she's trying to sell?
I don't have to. Hermia was under suspicion. We leaked a faulty device to her. All this thing will ever do is blow up in your face.
I need to go. I have to talk to my lawyer.
My discount.
Talk fast, Hermia. When the fines hit, you won't be able to afford him.
Ah, that was good. I've got to go file a few papers. Come by my table when you've got a minute.
It's down to 75. That's not so bad.
Hermia is going to be a very poor woman very shortly. Thanks for the help, Shepard. I love nailing Asari. So ageless and superior. Then you get them and they squeal like schoolgirls.
It must be nice having a job that you really enjoy.
I wanted to be a cop, or CSEC. But my family had bills. I needed the money a corporate job brought in. Besides, in this job, you don't see things that make it hard to sleep at night. White-collar crime is nice and clean. Hell, at least this time I didn't have to wear heels and a dress.
It must be hard, going undercover so often.
It's not so bad. Go new places, be new people. The only weird part is when you go home and try to talk to people, and you forget how to react. Like it's another cover, you know?
Deep down, part of you likes fooling people. That's what makes you good at it.
Part of me? Yeah. I grew up poor and working class. Now I walk around the rich and powerful, taking notes, getting evidence. And they never see me coming.
It's been a pleasure, Gianna.
You too, Shepard. See you around. Oh, hell with it. Mwah. Much better than an autograph. Take care of yourself, Shepard.
Hello, Commander Shepard. Liara will be pleased to see you.
You're Liara's assistant?
Yes. Liara relies upon me to acquire useful intelligence. I don't have her network of contacts, but I supply her with supplemental data. It's really an honor to work with her.
What's Liara's reputation here on Illium?
She is greatly respected. In a few short years, she's amassed a sizable network of connections. She could have even more political power than she already wields, if she weren't so focused on her personal goals. But I believe she should tell you about that, not me.
I'll talk to you later.
Of course, Commander.
Of course.
Have you faced an Asari commando unit before? Few humans have. I'll make it simple. Either you pay me, or I flay you alive. With my mind. Shepard! Nyxeris, hold my calls. Shepard. My sources said you were alive, but I never believed. It's very good to see you.
You have sources now?
A few. Sources, contacts. Even a little hired muscle. I've been working as an information broker. It's paid the bills since you... Well, for the past 2 years. And now you're back, gunning for the collectors with Cerberus.
That's not exactly public knowledge.
Neither is you being alive, Shepard. Information is my business now. And if you need information on finding people, I'm happy to help.
What about you, Liara? I could use your help on this mission.
I can't, Shepard. I'm sorry. I have commitments here, things I need to take care of.
What kind of things do you need to take care of? Are you in trouble?
No, no trouble. But it's been a long 2 years. I had things to do while you were gone. I have debts to repay. Listen, if you want to help, I need someone with hacking expertise, someone I can trust. If you could disable security at key points around Illium, you could get me information I need. That would help me a great deal.
What's this all about, Liara? Can't you just talk to me?
Don't you think I want to, Shepard? This isn't because I don't trust you. This is Illium. Anything I say is probably being recorded.
If it'll help you, I'll take care of it.
When you hack one, a server will open somewhere nearby for a short time. You can download data from there, if you hurry. Thank you, Shepard. This may help me pay a great debt.
There's an Asari named Samara here on Illium. Do you know where I can find her?
Samara. Yes. She arrived recently and registered with Tracking Officer Dara. You can find Dara at the transportation hub.
Why would Samara have to register with a tracking officer? Is she a criminal?
No. In fact, she's quite the opposite. Samara is a Justicar, one of an ancient sect of Asari warriors. Dara can tell you more.
I'm looking for Thane Krios. He's supposed to be here on Illium.
The assassin? Yes. He arrived here a few days ago. My sources tell me he may be targeting a corporate executive, Nissana Dantius. He contacted a woman named Serena. Serena has an office in the cargo transfer levels. Perhaps she can tell you where Krios is.
That was all just off the top of your head?
I'm a very good information broker, Shepard. The world of intrigue isn't that different from a dig site. Except that the dead bodies still smell.
Thanks for the help. That's all I needed to know.
Of course. If there's anything else I can help you with, let me know.
How's your own work going?
Everyone needs information, Shepard. You want to know why I don't drop everything to join you? I need to get that data. It should be about friendship or trust. But that's not the way it works on Illium. Let me know when you hack those terminals. Give me that, and I can talk to you.
If it'll help you, I'll take care of it.
When you hack one, thank you, Shepard.
Yeah.
This may help me pay a great debt.
I'll talk to you later, Liara.
All right.
Does living at a higher altitude make you more intelligent? Our report may surprise you. Data commissioned by the Architectural Union has noted a correlation between tested intelligence and height of habitat. New homes ranging from studio apartments to spacious rooftop mansions.
Listen, I know the data is vital to the Garrus family. Nissana Dantius didn't give us time to pack. I'm lucky I got out at all. Her mercenaries were starting to shoot. If she lets us back in, I'll get it, I promise. If not, well, we'll just have to hope.
Alien News would like to offer a clarification of our special report on notorious assassin.
Trust me, the goods coming in from the terminus systems are great for business.
I don't know, some of them seem dangerous.
That's the whole point. Danger means more contract work for us.
The store's over there, and don't get cute. The whole place is monitored.
That's so expensive. More health or assault rifle damage. Going assault rifle.
This is valuable.
Oh, blue rose of Illium. Let your roots dig deep into the hot soil of T'Chanka. Let our scorching sun and sheeting rain turn your supple beauty into strength. For if our love is to survive, it must grow thorns to pierce the hand of any that would uproot it.
What do you want? Sorry, that damn Krogan's love poems are getting on my nerves.
The Krogan is reading those love poems to get your attention?
His name is Char. We're kind of dating, but, well, we're on a break. And he's trying to show me how sensitive he is by, well, wooing me. It's really bad.
Why are the two of you on a break?
He's serious. Serious, as in talking about kids. Char is a great guy to date, but for something permanent... Krogans live long lives. It's not like dating a human where you just stick it out for a century till they die. No offense. It made me wonder if he really likes me. Or if he just wants kids. He can't have them any other way, you know. Because of the genophage.
It doesn't seem common for Asari to date Krogan. What brought you two together?
He's a fun guy. Really smart. Especially for a Krogan. And he's got a good job as a transport technician. It's fun to join a mercenary guild or dance at bars for a few centuries, but eventually you hit the matron stage, you know? Then you get your back tattoo removed, let your scalp go back to its natural blue, and settle down with someone dependable.
You need to talk to your boyfriend. He's just gonna keep shouting poetry until you do.
I know, but it's tough. I like him a lot. Hell, I love him. But I don't know if he's permanent bond material.
Look at him. He's obviously crazy about you.
Is he? I mean, what if he just wants to have kids? Am I just his baby-making machine? He said I wasn't, but...
If he said that, then you either trust him, so you have nothing to worry about, or you don't, and you've already decided.
I guess I hadn't thought about it like that. And I do trust him, if he said it. I'm going to talk to him. Here, I've given you a discount at the terminal. Thanks for the help. And I
stand here. No, no, thank you. Offer you a home. More fish. Hopefully they don't die.
What about you? Going to try and make it as a commando?
Why not? Every Asari has biotics. Might as well use them, right?
For example, you know that new drug, the one that causes permanent neural scarring?
That's horrible.
There's a 12-page contract for shipping, then a waiver for use. I charge for 50 hours, plus overtime.
You can sell something that dangerous with just a contract and a waiver?
These are the Terminus systems. Everything's dangerous, and...
I'm telling you, relax. Axe will never notice a few missing pieces.
No, I can't get in. Because it's a crime scene. It's all locked down. Eclipse works, some Justicar, I don't know. Nobody is ever going to see the extra merchandise. Oh, which is why we're going to be rich. No, I haven't had any luck yet. She insists it was legal. I'm going to call in a favor and have a friend examine the contract.
Chiala!
I don't know, that still sounds like an awful...
Captain Hannah Shepard has apparently turned down an Admiral Star and will remain in command of the Orizaba. The captain deemed her promotion to Admiral a political ploy and said that she could best honor her child's legacy by captaining a ship.
Where are you? No.
It's just, we're looking for weapons. What about a fish? She loves the garden. We could add a pond.
Shepard, this is Liara. I've got the data.
Maybe a shirt. Or a card. Illium, Eclipse might be fun for you. For me, it's the future. My clan's breeding strategy is at stake.
Don't Salarians think about anything?
Shepard, I don't suppose you'd remember me. I'm Shiala,
We met on Pharos during the Geth attack. Saren had given me to the Thorian creature as a slave, and you killed it. And saved me. I promised to help Zeus Hope recover. I'm actually here on Illium for just that purpose.
How is Zeus Hope doing?
We've done a lot of rebuilding. We even salvaged some useful material from the Geth ship you destroyed. The Exogeny researchers got called back to their headquarters, however, along with what was left of the Thorian.
Is it Exogeny pushing colonists around again, or did the Thorian somehow survive our fight?
No. Exogeny has been very supportive of Zeus Hope. They actually seem to want to help us survive, and the Thorian is dead. Though, after all you went through to kill it, I understand your concern. I fear that after our adventure on Pharos, my purpose on Illium will seem mundane by comparison.
Is there something I can do to help?
I'd appreciate it. I've reached the limits of my diplomatic abilities, and I prefer not to start trouble. Some of the colonists had health problems as a result of the Thorian control. We hired a colonial survey group to do some medical scans. But the medical contract apparently allows the company to perform invasive procedures without our consent. That's why I'm here.
Tell me more about the contract you signed for these scans.
Barrier Frontiers was interested in our problem. They offered to perform medical scans and deliver treatment for next to nothing. I should have known it was too good to be true. But we were desperate. In the fine print, we apparently agreed to let them perform invasive follow-up procedures if they deem it valuable. Which they have.
Wait a minute. Shiela, you were only green when the Thorian made you a clone. The real you was blue, like normal Asari.
Those health problems, I said, were related to the Thorian control. This is mine. A few months after the Thorian died, my skin pigment changed. My biotic abilities are unstable as well. I'm also having vivid dreams about my time with the Thorian. It is disconcerting.
What kind of health problems did the colonists
have? Headaches or muscle spasms, similar to what they experienced while under Thorian control. Sometimes, the colonists near another former Thorian victim shared sensations like heat or pain. It has to be a result of trace amounts of the Thorian's parasitic spores. You can see why we'd want it studied and cured.
I'll talk to the survey group.
I appreciate it, Shepard. The Barrier Frontier's representative knows about the issue.
Always helping people.
I saw your conversation, human. You're here to complain about the medical contracts those colonists from Pharos signed. I suggest you leave. Your life is short enough. Do not waste what time you have bothering me.
What's your problem with humans?
Not just humans, it's all of you. The Salarians and Turians are no better. The galaxy would be a better place if nobody but the Asari had ever dragged themselves out of the primordial muck.
You seem to forget that a human saved you from Saren and the Geth.
The Geth created by the idiotic Quarians? That a rogue Turian specter led in an attack? The Geth didn't start with the Citadel. They attacked your human colony, Eden Prime, first. You humans brought the Geth upon us. You and the Turians and the Quarians. My people's deaths are on your hands.
Whose deaths are we talking about exactly?
The mother of my daughters was killed on the Quarian homeworld during the initial Geth uprising. My daughters died on the Citadel when the Geth attacked. One worked in the embassy. The other was a greeter for the consort. I'm not speaking in hypotheticals, human. The aliens will never be my allies. The best they can do is give me useful medical data.
Why was your bond made on the Quarian homeworld?
Studying the Quarians. Not their technology, but their music. She loved all their art. Said they had old souls. I think that's where my daughters got it from. Both of them love talking with people, exploring new cultures.
They sound like wonderful people. The galaxy is lesser for their loss.
Yes, it is.
Do you think they'd want you to do this?
I didn't... Sending an amended contract. No more tests, no fees. There's enough grief in this galaxy. I don't need to add to it.
Did you get the star charts?
Yeah. I had to deal with Arrhenia, though. I feel like I need a shower.
What do you expect? She's a pure blood. They're all...
You did it. I just got the revised contracts. Thank you, Shepard. You've saved Zeus' hope again. I don't think I could have... Is it always like this? Yesterday's problems lingering in some new form. Isn't anything ever just fixed?
You've got the power to make a difference, Shiala. Not everyone does.
You're right. You gave us a chance by saving the colony. I can't let them down. I won't. Thank you for what you've done here, Shepard. I'll keep doing what I can. Maybe sometime when I'm not organizing the colony and you're not doing whatever you do.
Can I help you with something?
I'm looking for an Asari warrior named Samara.
Wait, why? Do you have a problem, or did she kill somebody already?
Relax, I just need to speak with her.
Good. Samara's the first Justicar I've seen on Illium. If I'm lucky, things will stay peaceful. She went to the commercial spaceport a few hours ago. If you want to get there, the pedestal on that balcony will summon a cab. Just be polite when you meet her. Justicars embody our highest laws, and they usually stay in Asari space. She's not used to dealing with aliens.
Is Samara really that dangerous?
If you follow the laws, you've got nothing to fear, and a Justicar would die without hesitation to protect the innocent. But their code orders them to stop lawbreakers, with lethal force in most cases, and everyone skirts the law somehow on Illium. If someone tried to bribe her, she'd be obliged to gun them down as a matter of honor. I'm hoping to avoid that.
Why are you worried about other species coming into contact with her?
If a Justicar kills an Asari, none of us questions it. But if she killed a human... Do you think the Alliance would understand her actions and respect her authority? You can't even figure out your own religions! It's a big diplomatic incident just waiting to happen.
Tell me about the Justicars.
They're a monastic order. They've given up their families and possessions to follow their code. Most of them are on some lifelong mission, but they'll always stop to deal with any injustice they encounter, which can be a problem. In some ways, they're a lot like the Spectres, undertaking personal missions.
Spectres are authorized by the Council. Who do Justicars represent?
What? That's like, I don't know, a good human metaphor. They represent their code, our code. It's closer to a religious group than a legal branch. No law-abiding Asari would question a Justicar's orders. Nobody becomes a Justicar for personal gain. And they die before breaking their oaths.
I'm looking for Samara.
Like I said, she's at the... You can hail a cab at the pedestal on that balcony over there.
Thanks for your help.
Good luck with the Justicar. Try not to piss her off.
All right, enough up here. Let's go down and do Miranda's thing. We're getting
sometimes
pretty long
here.
Sometimes
you say these things, and I don't know. Maybe it's because you had a Batarian father.
Wow, you're pulling that on me? My father was an excellent caretaker. And you're...
The word you're looking for is pure blood.
Look on the stock market, debt piling up. Perhaps you need to explore other options.
Dude, what is it? I think my cat just farted, dude, and it absolutely reeks. What did you do? Wow, that's terrible.
I need minimal heat.
Oh my god.
And speed.
Such a small little body. How did that come out of there?
Unexpected visitor in the form of a rare Jessicar calling herself Samara.
God.
The Systems Alliance Parliamentary Subcommittee for Transhuman Studies has awarded reparations for bionics suffering from this rare
group. It's okay. I'll think of something.
You said synthetic insights would buy me. You said it was an easy sale.
I assumed they would want an AI tech. Hello, can I help you with something?
Have you made this Quarian your slave?
We prefer the term indentured servants. Before you do anything hasty, know that this Quarian signed the agreement voluntarily, and her servitude contract is completely legal on Illium. If you actually want to help the Quarian, convince the Synthetic Insights representative to purchase her contract.
What if I bought her myself? I could let her go and everyone would be happy.
A gallant offer with three problems. First, her technical skill merits a contract of several hundred thousand credits.
There's also a fee for freeing me before my service period ends.
Exactly. And finally, you are clearly a traveler. Her service contract requires that she remain on Illium.
I don't want them to take me off to a mine somewhere.
Why did this Quarian sign herself into slavery?
I tried to play the stock market. I'm good with numbers, and I thought I had a way to make unlimited money. I lost everything. Then I got a credit line and lost that. Then I took out an illegal loan. You get the picture.
As part of our agreement, I paid off her debts. 5 years from now, she'll have a fresh start and excellent work references.
I'll talk to the Synthetic Insights rep and see what I can do.
Really? Thank you. I'd appreciate that.
I forgot how much stuff there is for her to do up here, man.
So then he says, oh, it's okay. Our amino acids are all different. So it's not like we can get diseases or anything if we go natural.
I'm telling you, this is why you shouldn't date humans.
So then I had to explain about cross-species fluid contact. Completely killed the mood.
Not to mention that you're a Quarian. How could he be so insensitive?
Can I help you with something?
How would you like to get your hands on an expert Quarian AI programmer?
If you'd like to submit a resume, I... Wait. Is this that slave? Synthetic Insights has no interest in purchasing slave labor. We're under enough scrutiny from the Citadel without engaging in practices the Council disapproves of. To be frank, we're hardly hiring anyone. The Geth attack on the Citadel didn't engender much love for artificial intelligence.
It sounds like Synthetic Insights is worried about its reputation. Hiring this Quarian would help.
Buying a slave helps our reputation. How exactly do you figure?
Purchase the contract, minus the fee for early emancipation, then free the Quarian and garnish wages for reimbursement.
Interesting. We look good for hiring a Quarian, and we can say that we freed slaves out of the goodness of our hearts. All right, I'll run up a contract. The board might wet its pants, but we could use the good publicity. This Quarian had better be good, though.
Boom. Easy enough.
Synthetic Insights just sent over the contract. I cannot thank you enough.
I'm happy to help.
Here, for your trouble. Now, if you'll excuse me, I'll get this service contract transferred.
Thank you. I'll stay out of trouble this time.
I still don't see why we're here. Salarians do not get married. My family simply negotiated a reproduction contract.
Whatever. It's the closest you guys get to a wedding. And that means you get a bachelor party. End of story.
I don't understand. Humans celebrate wedding contracts by tempting infidelity? That makes no sense.
Calm down, man. Don't embarrass me in front of the stripper.
What do Turians do? Do Turians do this too?
I'm just here for the drinks.
You said that bachelor parties are for very close friends. We're just co-workers.
We've been co-workers for 5 years, though. Aren't Solarian years like dog years?
Okay, now that's offensive. I appreciate the gesture, but my people don't even have sex drives the way humans do.
Uh-huh. Take a look at that, man. Everybody likes the Asari. Everybody.
But we actually reproduce by... My word.
She is very limber. I can appreciate her dancing in an aesthetic manner, but I don't have feelings of... She is a lovely shade of blue.
Okay, that makes my legs hurt just watching it. And my knees are meant to bend that way.
Welcome to Eternity. I'm Athena, Asari Matriarch, and bartender. What can I get you?
You're an Asari Matriarch? I thought Matriarchs served as honored advisors.
Right. Which I do here at this bar. I know, not what you'd expect. But nobody on Thessia wanted to listen to my wise counsel, so here I am. Dad was a Krogan who fought in the Rachni Wars. My mother fought in the Krogan Rebellions. I've pretty much seen it all.
What's it like, living for nearly 1,000 years?
Violent. Wars break out. Colonies get destroyed. Sometimes you hear good news, like a colony on Pharos surviving. That's the exception, though. You find peace in whatever arms will hold you. Turian, Elcor, Hanar. Even had a pureblood daughter. I was the father. Didn't work out. And one day you wake up, your figure's gotten matriarchal, and everyone else is too young to remember how the Quarians looked inside those suits.
Thanks for telling me about that.
That's what I'm here for, babe. Catch you anything else?
I'd like something to drink.
Sure. I'll set up a tab at the drink kiosk. Knock yourself out. Literally, if you want. Just don't drink anything for Turians or Quarians. Does nasty things to your insides. Once saw Krogan drink a liquefied Turian on a dare 6 or 7 centuries back. Nobody came out of that one looking pretty.
What's it like being an Asari Matriarch?
Pretty much like be...
Right. Don't even...
Alright. You deserve somebody who respects you. Somebody who's going to...
Ms. Lawson, I'm glad you've made it. We've had a complication.
What happened? Is Ariana all right?
She's fine. But you listed a man named Niket as your trusted source. He contacted me, warning that your father has sent Eclipse mercenaries to make a sweep. He suggested that the Mercs might be watching for you personally. He's offered to escort Ariana's family to the terminal instead.
He didn't mention anything about Niket.
He's a friend. He and I go back a long way.
Do you want to bring in any of your other Illium contacts, Ms. Lawson?
No. You and Niket are the only two I trust on this.
Making changes now could be dangerous. Are you sure you can trust Niket?
Absolutely. He's one of my oldest friends. I trust him with Ariana. Lentea, we'll follow Niket's suggestion. Shepard and I will take the car and draw their attention. Have Niket escort the family to the shuttle. Give him full access to the family's itinerary, just to be safe.
Understood, Ms. Lawson.
So the plan is for us to get shot down by Eclipse while your sister gets to safety?
Eclipse will be under orders to take my sister alive. They won't risk anything that could kill us.
I'm ready whenever you are, Miranda.
Thank you, Shepard. I appreciate this. I hadn't planned on Eclipse, but they never planned on you.
All right, who are we gonna take? Let's just keep Garrus. There we go.
Damn it! Eclipse mercenary gunships. They'll be dropping troops in the cargo areas.
Put us down in that cover behind them.
Let's hope they really do want to take us alive.
Hold fire! I said hold fire, damn it! I got this.
I always liked tech armor.
Since you're not firing yet, I trust you know who I am.
Yeah, they said you'd be in the car. You're the bitch that kidnapped our boss's little girl.
Kidnapped? This doesn't involve you. I suggest you take your men and go.
Think you've got it all lined up, huh? Captain Inyala's already moving in on the kid. She knows about Niket. He won't be helping you.
Should we be talking to Captain Inyala about this?
You don't want to talk to the captain. She's not as polite as I am. She's the best commando I've ever seen. I've seen her tear people in half with her biotics. And she's getting paid a lot to stop you.
She gets in my way, she'll never have a chance to spend it.
What do you mean, Niket won't be helping us?
Nothing you need to worry about. Nobody's gonna get killed unless you do something stupid. You walk away now, the girl goes back to her father, and everybody's happy.
Everybody but my sister. And me.
Wait, Miranda, you said she was your twin sister.
That what she told you? No, this crazy bitch kidnapped our boss's baby daughter. He's been looking for her for more than a decade.
It's complicated, Shepard. We share the same DNA, just not the same birthday.
You took a baby from the richest guy in the galaxy, lady. I don't know what your damage is, but you're not getting away with it.
You're not getting Miranda's sister. If you push this, it'll go badly for you.
Captain Inyala ordered us to give you one chance to walk away. This whole time we've been talking, my men have been lining up shots. When I say the word, we unleash hell on your squad. So I suggest you walk away nicely, unless you want things to get...
Right there! Kick their ass!
Oh wow, that's much better.
Grab cover!
Attacking target!
Ouch.
What else to worry about?
Back here that I missed.
Hang on, I've got one of their radios. I'll patch us in, see if I can get an idea of what we're up against. Shepard, I think I owe you an explanation. Ariana is my twin, genetically. But my father grew her when I was a teenager. She was meant to replace me. I couldn't let my father do to her what he did to me. So I rescued her. She's almost a woman now.
I can understand choosing to go your own way, but you stole a young child from her father.
If you knew my father, you would understand. I wasn't the first one he made. I was only the first one he kept. I was brought up with no friends, pushed to meet impossible demands. I wasn't a daughter to him. I don't know what I was. Ariana has had a normal life. I made the right decision.
If Eclipse knows where Ariana is, they'll be moving in on her soon. We need to hurry.
Agreed. I'm a bit worried by what the Merc said. If they've got to Niket somehow, this is going to be harder than I'd planned. According to the specs I reviewed, we'll need to cut through the cargo processing yard to get to Ariana.
I hope your friend can be trusted.
Absolutely. Niket is one of my oldest friends. I guess you could say he was my only real friend. He's the only person I didn't cut ties with when I left my father.
Is there a chance your father could be using Niket to get to you?
I'm sure he's tried, but Niket's one of the few people who understands what my father is really like. I trusted him with my life when I ran from my father, Shepard. He won't betray me now.
Let's go find Niket and Orion.
Right. They're on the far side of the conveyor line. Time your shots.
Ooh, got out of there quickly. That's not it.
We've been spotted.
Shot. Combat
drone
engaged!
You
this might be useful.
Is it valuable?
Authorized for lethal force.
Hostiles up ahead!
Engaging target!
I'm going to ground!
Going to cover!
Oh, shit.
We need They've seen us.
I'm not letting her get Orianna.
There we go!
Affirmative! Understood.
Understood.
Affirmative. Affirmative.
Hold fire on the unshielded hostiles!
Fire is away!
Deploying tech overload.
Stand down!
Enemies in front!
Eclipse operatives have attempted to delay you by disabling the elevators. I am overriding their lockdown.
Affirmative.
Stay tight, Eclipse!
Hostile engage.
Right.
idea.
Maybe the captain knows we're listening in, and she's feeding misinformation about Niquette making a switch. Or maybe it means something else.
Elevator music.
Niquette wouldn't do that. Damn it, why would this thing go any faster?
What makes you so sure that Niquette wouldn't turn on you?
He could have turned on me when I ran away. I'm sure my father tried to buy him off. If he didn't do it then, why would he do it now?
Did Niquette know that you took Orianna from your father?
No, he just found out about that recently. It was too personal to involve someone else. I never really thought about it, but maybe... No, he'd have to understand why I did it. He knows what I went through.
We won't know anything until we find Niquette.
And then I'll have a word with this captain and Yala.
Listen to me. I've got authorization to change their booking.
I'm sorry, sir. We're under security lockdown. Until the situation in the cargo terminal is resolved, no passengers can be rebooked.
This isn't worth my time, Niquette. I get paid regardless of how the girl gets there.
No. I was told that I could handle this my way. We're not traumatizing the family any more than we... Miri.
This should be fun.
Niquette, you sold me out.
How do you want to handle this, Miranda?
Why, Niquette? You were my friend. You helped me get away from my father.
Yes, because you wanted to leave. That was your choice. But if I'd known that you'd stolen a baby...
I didn't steal her. I rescued her.
From a life of wealth and happiness? You weren't saving her. You were getting back at your father.
How did Miranda's father turn you?
They told me you'd kidnapped your baby sister all those years ago. They said I could help get her back peacefully. No trauma to the family. I told them you'd never do that. They could go to hell. And you finally told me what you'd done. I called them back that night.
Why didn't you call me, Niquette? We've been through a lot. You could have at least let me explain.
I deserve to know that you'd stolen your sister, Miri. I deserve to know you were with Cerberus. But I had to hear it from your father first.
How much did Miranda's father pay you?
A great deal.
Damn it, Niquette! You were the only one I trusted from that life.
He knew you felt that way. That's why he bought me.
So you just took his money?
Don't get holy with me, Miri. You took his money for years.
I knew Eclipse was willing to get their hands dirty. But kidnapping a kid?
I'm not stealing her. I'm rescuing her. Come on, Niquette. Let's finish this bitch off and get out of here.
Take your best shot.
I was just waiting for you to finish getting dressed. Or does Cerberus really let you whore around in that outfit?
Whether or not you agree with Miranda, Orianna has been with her family for years now.
Her father can still give her a better life.
You don't know what my father wants for her.
I know that I've been poor, Miri. I didn't much care for it.
He wants to take a girl away from the only family she's ever known. Doesn't that tell you what he really is?
If Niquette knows about Orianna, then your father does too. Relocating her won't work.
Miranda's father has no information about Orianna. I knew you had spy programs in your father's system, Miri, so I kept it private. I'm the only one who knows.
Which means that you're the only loose end. This isn't how I wanted it to end, Niquette.
Miranda, wait! You don't want to do this.
This has to end here, Shepard. My father will keep trying to find Orianna.
Maybe Niquette can help. Talk to your father. Just say you got here first.
I'll tell him that you hid her. That I don't know where she is.
I never want to see you again, Niquette.
Done. Now, if you don't mind, I have a shipment to deliver.
You'll die for that, bitch!
We've been spotted.
Go get him!
Put them down.
All the test units.
ready to burn!
Combat your drone, watch out.
I need support!
Could be more Eclipse mercs near the shuttle. I want to make sure Orianna and her family get on safely. Believe Niket sold me out. I didn't even see it coming.
Even with all your upgrades, you're human, just like the rest of us.
But I let it get personal and I screwed up. Why didn't you let me kill him? I could have handled that. But watching him get gunned down by that Asari bitch.
You still cared for him, even if he betrayed you.
You're right. And my father knew it. He used that against me. It's always been like this. My father gave me anything I ever wanted. But there was always a hook, an angle for his long-term plan. I threw away everything he ever gave me when I ran. Except Niket. Weakness on my part?
You can't toss aside everything you care about just to be safe.
It's okay, Shepard. My father hurt me, but he didn't break me. As much as he tried to turn me into exactly what he wanted, I'm my own person.
You still have Orianna.
My father didn't give her to me. I rescued her, but yes, you're right. I still have something. Thank you. No sign of Eclipse. It looks like we're clear. There she is. She's safe. With her family. Come on, we should go.
Don't you even want to say hello?
It's not about what I want, it's about what's right for her. The less she knows about me, the better. She's got a family. A life. I'll just complicate that for her.
She doesn't need any details. But would it really be so bad for her to know she has a sister who loves her?
I guess not.
Go on. We'll wait here. I'll deal with it.
Take pictures.
Touch me and I will smear the walls with you, bitch!
Enough! Stand down, both of you.
The cheerleader won't admit what Cerberus did to me was wrong.
It wasn't Cerberus. Not really. But clearly you were a mistake.
Screw you! You've got no idea what they put me through. Maybe it's time I showed you.
Our mission is too important to let personal feelings get in the way.
Fuck your feelings. I just want her dead.
You both know what we're up against. Save your anger for the collectors.
I can put aside my differences until the mission's over.
Sure, I'll do my part. I'd hate to see her die before I get a chance to fillet her myself.
You two gonna be okay?
It's a good thing you came by when you did. As long as she does her job, we'll be fine. Thanks, Shepard.
All right, well, that puts us in about 3 hours, I think. Like 2 hours, 50 minutes total. And I was going to go pick up Thane and Jessicar, but looks like that's not going to happen tonight. What time is it? It is 4 a.m., so yeah, that's time for me to go, guys. Anyways, thank you guys so much for watching. Like I said, next time, hopefully we'll get around to getting Justicar and Mr. Krios, but we will see how that works out as usual. Anyway, thank you guys so much. As always, hit me up on Twitter, at SlyNation, or even on Facebook if you want to. I don't check it that much, but it definitely needs some attention. Anyways, I'll see you all next time. Later, y'all.